Good morning. The Lord be with you. Friends, as we begin our time together this morning, I want to invite you to stand in the presence of the Lord as we sing together. Some of you may know this. If you do, sing on out. If not, you'll catch on. It simply goes like this. My hope is built on nothing less than Jesus' blood and righteousness. I dare not trust the sweetest frame, but wholly lean on Jesus' name. On Christ the solid rock I stand, all other ground is sinking sand. All other ground is sinking sand. On Christ the solid rock I stand, all other ground is sinking sand. All other ground is sinking sand. Amen. You know, I remember growing up in a little Baptist church in Shreveport, Louisiana, and often in the mornings, we would wake up being reminded that Jesus is the one whom we follow, whom we look toward as our guide and as our Savior and as our friend. And so we wake up in the morning with our mind stayed on Jesus. I can hear my grandmother, we called her Tootie. I could hear her voice singing in the morning, say, woke up this morning with my mind, and it was stayed on Jesus. Yeah, woke up this morning with my mind, and it was stayed on Jesus. Well, I woke up this morning with my mind, and it was stayed on Jesus. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. She said, I'm walking and talking with my mind, and it is stayed on. Talking with my mind, and it is stayed on Jesus. Yes, I'm walking and talking with my mind, and it is stayed on Jesus. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Singing, I'm singing and shouting with my mind. Shouting with my mind, 'cause it is stayed on Jesus. Yes, I'm singing and shouting with my mind, and it is stayed on Jesus. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. By this time she say, ain't no harm, it ain't no harm to have your mind.
My burden.
song that comes to us from Argentina. It's in the style of a tango. It was written at a time just as the liberation theology meant that God has a special favoritism toward the poor. Written for people who needed to have hope. The song is called Tenemos Esperanza. And it simply reminds us that because of Christ's resurrection, we can have hope. Because Christ came for us, we have hope. Can I get an amen? Amen. Because Christ came to enter in our journey, because he broke the silence of our sorrow, because he filled the whole world with his glory and came to light the darkness of our mind, because he came a stranger, poor and lonely, because he lived proclaiming love and healing, because he opened hearts of hungry people and brought new life to all who would receive it. In hope we are forever celebrating, with courage in our struggle we are waiting, in trust and reassurance we are claiming. This is our song of freedom for all people. In hope we are forever celebrating, your courage in our struggle we are waiting, in trust and reassurance we are claiming. This is our song. Because he dealt with all the hungry merchants, and he declared the evil of their doings, because he lifted every child and woman and put aside the proud and hateful people, because he bore a cross for all our sorrow and knew our every weakness and temptation, because he opened hearts of hungry people and brought new life to all who would receive it. In hope we are forever celebrating, with courage in our struggle we are waiting, in trust and reassurance we are claiming. This is our song of freedom for all people. In hope we are forever celebrating, with courage in our struggle we are waiting, in trust and reassurance we are claiming. This is our song. Because his triumph came one early morning, and he defeated death and fear and sorrow, because he moved triumphant to the future to bring a kingdom saving all tomorrow. In hope we are forever celebrating, with courage in our struggle we are waiting, in trust and reassurance we are claiming. This is our song of freedom for all people. In hope we are forever celebrating, with courage in our struggle we are waiting, in trust and reassurance we are claiming. This is our song. This is our song, and with the Spirit we pray that God would renew the face of the earth, that God would completely change our darkness into light, our sorrow into celebration and rejoicing. It is the vision of new creation, where there is no death, the sea is no more, where God is the light that surrounds and invades us. So as you are seated, I want to invite you to pray that the Spirit would come and renew the face of the earth. Spirit who broods, Spirit who sings, mothering bird, peace in your wings. Come from within, come make us one, come and renew the face of the Spirit of truth, laser and light, searching the path, seeking the right. Come from within, come make us one, come and renew the face of the Spirit of love, larger than law, quick to forgive, keeping no score. Come from within, come make us one, come and renew the face of the earth. Spirit of hope, never subdued. Spirit of God, Spirit of good, we sing. Come from within, come make us one, come and renew the face of the earth. Come from within, come from within, come make us one, come and renew the face of the earth. One more time, come from within. Come from within. Come make us one. Come and renew the face of the Amen.
Thank you, DeAndre. Welcome. Good morning. It will be another very good day. I look forward to being with you during this day as we continue our agenda. We will adjourn, hopefully, by the time certain that's printed on the agenda. That is my intention, which means that I'm going to be moving us rapidly at times, and which I try to do anyway, but I'll be doing that. I believe that Cheryl Murphy is going to be giving our prayer, so Cheryl, we gladly welcome you.
Good morning. I feel as if the spirit of last night's worship service is still upon us, so as we settle in and begin the work at hand, let us pray. Almighty God, thank you for the gift of today. As we gather in this beautiful sanctuary, surrounded by dear friends and colleagues, new friends and committed Christians, we thank you for this sacred time. Today we'll be blessed by the witness of wise and motivating speakers. We will be blessed by the leadership of our bishop and conference leaders. Be present with them, that at all times we can see your work, hear your words, and experience your love stamped upon their hearts. Lord, we are grateful to you for the clergy that are serving the many churches in the North Texas communities. The call on their lives to be present and witnessing to all that you are and all that you do through them is the light of Jesus Christ. Lord, we lift up praises for the laity that have taken time from their personal and professional lives to be about the work of our conference. Without their witness, passion, and faithful service, your message would not reach the masses in our cities and communities. Lord, may our work, our words, our witness glorify you today. May we be the people, the disciples you need for the holy work at hand. May your spirit be present in every breath, in every step, in every conversation. May your spirit be the witness that we are the hands and feet of Christ here and now. Lord, we lift ourselves to you this day and every day. And all God's people said, amen.